Our next talk is from Paul Desranges, a OSM contributor from France, from the Grenoble group of OSM contributors, and he's going to talk about advertising mapping and using OpenStreetMap for the protection of landscape. So thank you, Paul.
Yes, hello. Hello, thank you. Let's start. So a particular usage of OpenStreetMap for the protection of landscape. So I am Paul Desranges, as it was said. So I am from Grenoble in the French Alps, and I am a member of the OSM group of contributors of this town. I have been using for on trying to improve the advertising tag specification during several years, and I wish I can share knowledge on that and get your feedback, and as well try to raise awareness on the topic. So this is the outline. We'll go through the various advertising devices existing. Then we'll ask the question, is it necessary, is it useful to map advertising map? What for? Why should we bother doing that? And I will try to convince you that the answer is yes. And after, we'll see how to map the advertising device with various tools, and we'll make a short status on how we are on this mapping. So there are many advertising devices in landscape. I can show you some more. I'm sure you can recognize some of the advertising devices from your country or your town. All kinds, all formats, all size, and there are very numerous, a lot of them. So for example, if I start at the beginning, at the top left, you have billboards. This is a French format of billboards. So 12 square meter or 8 square meter. They mustn't be higher than 6 meter high in France, but you have bigger format like that in USA. Everything is bigger in America, maybe 60 square meter. Or in Portugal as well, you have very large billboards along the motorways, a lot of them. Some of them are lit by spots like that, or lit by neon ramps, or lit from the inside by transmission. Two side as well this way. Sometimes on pole, big poles, or several poles. So this is a billboard. These are the billboards. You have other billboards on wall, like this one, or wall-painted billboard as well. You have giant tarps, wallscape, giant on all buildings, like in Portugal, this one. We have many of them as well in France, during work, on scaffolding, things like that. There are smaller formats, like this one, which are lollipops or poster box. Sucette, in French, we say. Or other poster box on mast with digital screen inside. I'm sure there are other formats in your country. We have as well sign. So sign are advertising device which denote an activity which takes place at the place where the device is installed. So we have totems like that. So in France, they mustn't be higher than 6.5 meter high, and even 8 meter if it's not larger than 1 meter. And this one, for example, is a sign which maybe is 12 or 15 meter high, and which is totally illegal in France, but we have many in any way. Or a big sign as well in Portugal. Quickly, so we have many other formats. These ones are very common in France. We have hundreds of thousands like that. It is indication board to denote an activity which is taking place maybe 3 minutes away or 5 minutes drive from that along the road. Most of them are no more legal in France. They're called pré-enseigne in French. Or many other formats. And we have as well advertising on urban furnitures, to traffic shelters, newspaper kiosks, public toilets. We have as well a lot of columns. In France, the columns are reserved for advertising for showbiz, look only theater, movies, concerts, things like that. No other commercial message. And in France as well, we have this format of boards, which is reserved for free expression and non-profit organization. So every town in France must have some boards like that, proportional to the number of population, so that a non-profit organization can make advertising. This is not really advertising, more electronic digital display. Advertising in public space, of course, public space and public landscape belongs to everybody, and it can be an issue to have advertising everywhere, too many, too much, and so on. So in France, we have been having a legislation for more than 100 years related to advertising in public space. At the beginning, it was only to protect the heritage, the remarkable sites, the historical sites, things like that, because economic power or big company wanted to have advertising, but it was not nice to have that close from monuments. So there were some rules introduced 100 years ago. And as I said, we had as well to reserve space for freedom of expression and for non-profit organization, not only commercial message. After a long time after was considered as well the people and not only the monuments and the historical site, and because advertising can be a nuisance, it's a visual pollution sometimes when there are too many. So yeah, there was some restriction introduced to limit the number depending on the size of the town and things like that. Where some consideration were introduced to limit the power, the light of the advertising device as well. So all of that makes the legislation, which is very complex. There are many dispositions to limit the size, the height, to limit the number, depending on the size of the town, depending on the proximity with the roads, proximity with monuments, many rules which are quite complicated to understand, but to know and to be aware of. Advertising in society in France, at least, there are many organizations which try to fight against too many advertising. Some of them are very radicals. I'm part of an organization which makes some awareness campaign like this one. So we just cover, we don't break anything, we don't remove anything, we don't tag anything, we just put temporary tarps on the billboards just to warn the people, to have newspaper and to make awareness. So it's written, pas de pub, des arbres, meaning no ad, only trees. So we have very little means, in fact. We have no subsidy, we are only volunteers, and we are against companies which are very powerful. Economic power is very, very rich, and so on. So they can, they always try to change the rules to get more place to have display for advertising. So it's a regular fight against them. And as it was said, I come from Grenoble. Grenoble was a little famous in 2014 because the municipality did not renew the contract which linked the city with the advertising company. And then more than 300 advertising devices have been removed from the public space at that time. And sometimes it was huge billboards, so that had to remove as well the concrete on the ground because the municipality wanted to plant trees instead. So for all this reason, it's quite important for the citizen to control or to have some kind of control on the number of advertising devices which appear in landscape, so that we can know how many there are, what is the density, to be able to compare public policy of same town, same kind of towns, to follow change in time. And in any case, it is legitimate to have into OSM database all what appears in the landscape. And as the advertising device appears in the landscape, it's normal to have them. So we can imagine if the inventory of advertising would be well done, that we can do some math against that, and then be able to measure the advertising pressure, for example, or yeah, many things which could be done. But so far, the inventory is far from being done. A lot, it's just starting, in fact, so there are a lot of work. So how to tag that into OSM? So if you don't know anything, you can just put one tag, which is PanMade equal advertising. But it's better to use the advertising tag and to give a value. And the value gives the form factor or the external aspect of the device. So if I come back on the first slide very quickly, so you would say for this one, advertising equal billboard. Advertising equal billboard as well. Advertising equal tarp. Advertising equal poster box. Advertising equal totem. Advertising equal columns. Advertising equal board. Advertising equal poster box. I just do the first one. Okay, so this is the advertising value. Then you can, most of the time, the advertising device which are set into OSM have only this attribute which is set, but you can add more attribute to be more precise. So to give, for example, the visibility of the device, so house, street, or era, depending on the way the device is seen, is visible. Number of side is something very easy to set. If the device is lit or not lit, and the way it is lit. If the device is animated or not, sometimes you have winding papers, sometimes you have rotating triangles, sometimes you have screen, sometimes you have digital display or rotating columns as well. The way it is supported, is it on mast, on pole, is it on wall, is it on fence, on scaffolding? The size of the device, so it's not very easy to measure precisely, but there are standard formats which can be used, which can be recognized easily. So for example, in France, we have this kind, which is 1.5 meter width, 1 meter high. Poster box, most of the time, they are 1.3 against 2.15. Wall billboard, 3.5 against 2.7, a bigger one, 4.2 against 3.2. The height of the billboard, which should be the total height from the lowest to the highest point. The operator, the one which is operating the billboard. The unique reference of the billboard. Then we can even add more be more precise to set if it's not easy to know sometimes, is it on private land or public land? What kind of message is displayed? Is it, most of the time it's commercial message, but it can be information or it can be showbiz or it can be political during election campaigns, things like that. You can set this only if it's a permanent message, of course. If it changes over time, you don't have to set it. Then others, more for French, is the billboard open to everybody to display its own poster, or is it private and only for commercial message of the company? The way the billboard is orientated, is it front to the flow of people and vehicles? Is it reverse, is it parallel, or is it multi on a crossroad, for example? Okay. So there are some tools. I've been working on some tools to help the contribution of on this topic. So there are presets for GOSM, OSM contributor profile, and map contrib theme. So I will show very quickly. So the preset in GOSM is quite complete. There is a French version and which is more complete on international version. So if you choose so grounded, wall billboard, poster box on public transportation shelter, and all of that enables you to have all the default value for your device. So it goes very quickly. This This one cannot be displayed. I had a nice icon to show, but I don't know why. So there are as well a profile for the OSM contributor Android application, which are being built. There are as well a team in Map Contrib, which is a web application to help the contribution. So you have already all the attributes which are preset, which are prepared for you. So this is Grenoble. Even if the advertising have been removed from the public space, we still have a lot. For example, on traffic transportation shelters, or we have on private property. So now the contribution on advertising is starting. In France, we have something like more than 10,000 device set, but there are many others. Maybe five. I don't know the number, but it's very large. In Italy, you have some of them. It's starting as well. In Germany, I can show some of them, and I've prepared some stats per country as well, so showing that this is a topic which interests more the French at the moment, and I hope it will start in other countries. So the number of usage of advertising in some countries, then for billboard, so France, Germany, USA, advertising column is used in Germany, mostly, poster box, Germany and France, sign, USA, France, Germany. For totem, okay, board. So there is one rendering map which has been worked out by a French contributor, which is maybe here today, which show specifically the advertising on a OSM map. There exist, so I sometimes prepare some UMAP to show public policy on specific towns. I don't know if we can look at one of them, but it's a tool which can be used for citizens to show the number of advertising devices in their village. So in Boulazac, in France, not a small village, a small town. I have as well worked on a UMAP to make the inventory of a specific company in France. So they have 100 shops in France, magasins, shop in France, and some of them have illegal devices. For example, I can show the red one. There is photo. So you can see they're very huge, and they're higher than 8 meter, which should be the rule. So there are 10 of them have issues with regulation. Escape. So OSM can be a great tool for citizens to keep control on the number of advertising devices, to follow public policy on a town, and this is a nice way to use OSM for people interested in landscape. So I don't know if you have any questions. I precise, I'm not a professional. I'm just doing that on my leisure time, from time to time, and.
Why is it a subject that only interests French people for the while? And how can we interest more people around the world to contribute on this subject?
Yes, it's a great question. So I wish more people contribute on that topic. So that's why I'm here today, because I want to make more advertising on the advertising tag. So the I think it's a concern in all countries, in fact. So so far the French are concerned, but it can be an issue in any countries. But so far the specification on advertising tag is a little French, maybe, because there was not many contribution from many countries, from Germany as well. But there are other formats, other size, other things in other countries, more digital display, screens, things like that. In Milan, I've seen a lot. So I'm sure that the advertising tag needs to be completed. And I hope that other people from other countries will try to use that tag to add more devices.
Okay, if there are no more questions, we can thank Paul. Okay. Thanks again.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.